out today. Me and the children's church had put together a little play. It's called When You Are Tested. And so we just give God the glory for their the time that he blessed them with. So in the beginning, God created everything. At first, the earth was filled with void. It was nothing there, just darkness. And God is in the business of creating. So he created the light. He said, let there be light. And there was light. And he called the darkness night. And that was the first day. Then God kept on creating for about 5 days. He made the sea and the animals that's in the sea and the animals that's in the air and the trees and the field. And he made all of those things. And on the sixth day, God must have said, I want somebody in my likeness, in my own image. So I'm going to take you to a scene when God made the first man that we call Adam. God made Adam out of the dust and breathed into his nostrils. And man became a living being.
Adam, you may eat from all the trees in the garden, but not the tree of good and evil. You shall surely die.
Wow, I have all these animals, all this greenery, this whole garden is just amazing and perfect. But I have no one to call my own, no mate, no friend. So long.
See? So God see that man was not good by himself. He put man in a deep sleep. And he took from his rib. And God created woman.
Amen.
Bones, my bones, flesh is my flesh, I shall call you woman. Woman, you may eat from every tree and everything in this garden, but from the tree of good and evil, or else you shall surely die.
That's Eve. So let us see if Eve listened to what her husband told her, and let us see if Adam listened to what God told him. So Adam was just roaming around the garden. I don't know where he was, but Eve was somewhere by a tree she wasn't supposed to be by.
Had God told you you should not eat of every tree of the garden?
He said, I give you from all of these trees, but the good and evil all will die.
You surely not die. You'll be like up for knowing good and evil.
So Eve seen that the fruit looked good to her eyes, and she took it, and she ate, and she gave it to her husband. Ooh, let's see what happens now.
No, woman, you're naked. Come on.
Adam, where are you?
I'm here.
Why are you hiding? How do you know you are naked?
The woman that you created, she tempted me to eat the apple from the garden from the good and evil.
Eve, where are you? Why did you give your husband the apple?
It was a baby. It was the apple.
Well, you all have made me mad now. Adam, you will work the sweat of your brows. The land will no longer work for you. You will work for the land. From dust you have came, and from dust you will return. Eve, you will have very bad pain when you give birth. And serpent, you will crawl on your belly for eternity. Now all three of you, leave my garden.
That we must all ask ourselves. So we see here what happens from people that failed the test. But now I want to take you to a land called Oz. For a man that went through a strong test, one of the strongest tests in the Bible. And we don't know, should we find out if he cursed God or give up his faith? I'm going to take you to a time, as we all know him as Job.
Satan, what are you doing here?
Oh, nothing. Just roaming around, seeing who I may devour.
Have you considered my servant Job? He's a blameless, upright man. I will allow you to test him, but do not lay a finger on his body.
Satan first did what he wanted to do with Job. Job said, naked I came in, and naked I'll go out. Wow. What faith is that? To say, naked I came in, and naked I'll go out. But a lot of us ain't saying that. No. We're getting mad when a job let us down. We're blaming God and saying, God, why'd you let this happen? That's right. We're doing it. We all have done it. Over small things. Over why my cereal is not in the market. Mm-hmm. They know I like the cereal. I come here every Wednesday. Help us, Lord. Right. But Job lost everything. And Job had to understand it, that naked he came in and naked he'll go out. That God is still God. And now I'll take you to a scene when Job is tested again.
God, yes, he has passed my first test.
I know. As I told you, he's a blameless, upright man.
But surely, if you let me hurt him, he will surely curse your name.
I will allow you to touch him, but spare his life.
Job is a very, very deep story, and a lot of us read it, but we don't really look into the deep that this was somebody's life. And this man was trying his best to do everything right, and he loved God. He even did prayer for his children, because he was scared that they might have cursed God in their own hearts. But yet, he still had to go under the test. So, I just wonder, like, you know, when these things happen to us, hopefully not as like this, will we stand up like Job? Can God give our names up and say, have you my servant? Or are we too fickle? Let's see what happens in the next scene when after Job was tested the second time.
Job, oh, my dear wife, you have came to console me.
Hello.
Yes.
Curse God's name.
What
he has done to us.
This is not
our kids, our cattle.
This is not the doing of God, it's the doing of the devil. I will not curse his name, you foolish woman.
No, no. Look what he has done. Our children, our cattle, they're all dead.
This is not the work of God. Leave now and do not return.
Thank you.
all be saved. We're Christians because Jesus loved us. These people did not come in love. They came with scriptures and religion, and they couldn't figure out why this happened. They didn't understand the suffering part. They only understood the praise. So, do we do that when somebody's going through deep waters? Do we comfort them, give them a hug, tell them Jesus loves you? Or do we say, what have you done? You ain't filled out 25 applications. You've been broke for 3 years. I told you I lost everything, but did you fill out 25 applications? Help us, Lord. But just like God takes away, he can also restore. And now, I'm going to take you to a scene of restoration.
Job.
Yes?
Haven't I made everything?
Yes, you have.
Did I make the heavens?
Yes.
Did I make the earth? Mm-hmm. Do the angels sing to me, Job?
Yes, they do.
Did I give you everything you had?
Yes.
Can I take it from you?
Yes.
Now, Job, you stepped out of line. You even questioned my righteousness. Do you repent?
Yes, I do.
And now, I will show you that I am the great I am, that I give and I take away. And now, Job, I will bless you with a wife, 10 more kids, all your cattle, more than you had before, and your wealth, since you have so much faith.
Wow. Thank you.
And the boils are gone, Job. Stop scratching. Your health, too.
Thank you so much.
Job, you must always remember that I will never leave you nor forsake you, no matter what. Here is your wife, and here are your kids.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
And ladies and gentlemen, that is when you are tested. That scene. Thank you. So I just want to give the children's church some time to get in their regular outfits, and they want to talk to y'all about what they learned and how this was a blessing. I thank all y'all for coming out. I thank Naomi for the wig for Eve. I thank Sade for shining all the costumes. And more than anything, I thank Jesus Christ. For allowing us to have this and all of y'all being here and supporting them, because they worked really, really hard. So I thank y'all. They just waited to come out and tell what they learned, and then we're going to end it right there.
Continue your journey with God.
still fine.